So we are going to solve the sum of Yash Kumar. So Yash Kumar owns 3 houses. Find out his taxable income of the house property for the assessment year 2020-21 from the following information. Here the SSE is having the 3 house. So for that purpose, they have specified the first one is flat. That is let out. Number 2 is tenement. That is self-occupied. That means Yash Kumar is staying in that tenement. And the third is the raw house, which is also let out. So the 3 different types of house. The Yash Kumar is owning, is owner of the house. So according to the question and according to the adjustment, we are going to solve the sum for the three houses. So in only the house that is tenement is self-occupied, other 2 are let out. So when the house is self-occupied, so you know that according to the section 23 subsection 2A, the answer is going to be what? Nil. For the NA, just complete. So now we are going to solve the sum. So Yash Kumar owns the 3 houses. Find out the taxable income. So all the information. First we are going to solve for the only the flat. Then we will solve for the tenant. Then we will solve for the raw house. So 3 different. So for the 3 different houses we are going to solve in the different columns. So first I am talking about the flat. I am discussing that. We will solve that and we will go to the tenant and then we will go to the raw house. So flat is let out. So annual rent 15,000, fair rent 15,000, municipal assessment 18,000, standard rent they are not specified. Tax paid by the owner is what they have specified is 500, and the tax paid by the tenant is 2,000. So listen, when the tenant is paying the municipal tax, you are not going to get the deduction of it. When the tenant is paying the municipal tax, you are not going to get the benefit of that of the tenant who has paid. You are paying, you are getting the benefit. But tenant is paying, એટલે ભાડું તો ઈને તો તમને એમાં તમને ડિડક્શન મળી રહે. અહીંયા તો લખી પડતો હાઉસ બને ને ફ્લેટ માં ઇન્ટરેસ્ટ ઓન કન્સ્ટ્રક્શન કરંટ ઇયર ઓનલી 1000 અને કેપિટલ ઇઝ ટોટલ કીધું 5000. અગર કેપિટલ ઇઝ 5 વર્ષની અંદર ઘર બની એટલે છેલ્લા 5 વર્ષમાં તમને તમે અત્યારે ડિડક્શન કરતો વાંધો નથી. પણ હજી નથી થયું તો ઘણા એમ બાકી છે તો એનું બનશે. અહીંયા આપણે છે ને વેકેન્સીનું ઘર તો ખાલી નથી, ઘર એનું બની 2000 રેવન્યુ હતું. તો 2019-20 થોડી એવું ડિડક્શન મળે. ઇટ ઇઝ નોટ પોસિબલ દેટ યુ આર ગોઈંગ ટુ ગેટ ધ ડિડક્શન ઓફ 2000 રેવન્યુ. સો દેટ ઇઝ કોમ્પ્લિકેટેડ નાઉ. સો નો કેપિટલાઇઝેશન અલાઉડ ઇન ધીસ સમ એન્ડ રેન્ટ નોટ રિકવર્ડ. સો બેક ધેટ સાથે કઈ અર્ધે સ્પાર અગર એ હોય તો. So first of all, we solve the house rent. So computation of taxable income from house property. Previous year, 1920. So for house 1, so house 1 is what? Flat, and it is also let out. So the particular is not specified here. Standard rent is there. part they have specified is tax paid by the tenant. So that they have not specified and not writing. And if it has specified, then also I am not going to include in this part.
So now interest. For current year interest is 1000. Capitalized interest is 5000. But this I am not going to include here. Why? Because the completion of the work is in 2000, completed in 2011. So after that 5 years, so within 2016-17, after that we are going to make the deduction. So here it is 2021 assessment. So here also vacancy, there is no vacancy, and in required register address is also not specified. So we will calculate easy. So according to the step one is one higher value between the fair rent and consumer rent is 18. So and the standard rent whichever is your, there is no standard rent. So higher value will be consumer and fair. So higher value between municipal valuation and or fair rent. There is no standard deduction, so I am not specifying. So higher is what? 18,000. Step 2. Actual rent received or receivable. Here there is no tenant ability specified given the bank debts. So directly I will write a 14,000. Now step 3. So in step 3, the higher of step 1 or step 2, whichever is higher, we have to be included. So higher between step 1 or 2. So is what 18,000. And the step 4. Step 3 minus vacancy. Here no vacancy, so directly I will write out the 18,000 as a GA. So now the next part. So in next part is GAV is what? 18,000 less municipal tax. Less tax paid by owner. So tax owner is paying the tax of ₹500. Yet tenant is not paying for every in the deduction. So, NAV is going to be 17,500. Clear? Yep. Now the next part. Less specific deduction at 30% of NAV. So, so 5,250. Now specific reduction. In that the first is standard reduction. Standard reduction. So less specific. Yeah, sure.
The construction is completed in the year. The construction of the work on the flat, specify the word flat, because the, there are three houses. So specify the word flat. It is completed on 2011. So we are not going to get the reduction. So we will do less this figure. This is 6,250. Yeah. So income from house property is 70,500 minus 6,250 is going to be 11,250 is the answer. 11,250 is the answer. So solve this one, then we will solve for the tenement that is self occupied. So now for the second part we are going to solve is for the tenant. First I am discussing the regarding the tenant relationship. So now listen, annual rent, no use, and even they are not specified. Fair rent, also no use. Municipal assessment, no use. Standard rent, no use. Tax payment, also no use, because you are getting directly the NAV here. So if it is tax free, also we are not getting the benefit. After that, tenant interest for construction 6,000. Listen carefully, 6,000 for the current year. We are going to get the benefit of that. Capitalized is total 30,000. So after seeing the word capitalized, see the date when it is completed. Directly capitalized interest is good. See the date too. Complete that is work. कंपनी अहिया जिन से 2016 तो 5 वर्ष लाख अंदर से मंथ्स सो 30,000 डिवाइडेड बाय 0.5 तो आंसर अराउंड में जाओ से कितना हो से 6,000 सो 30 डिवाइडेड बाय 6,000 सो यू आर गोइंग टू गेट द बेनिफिट ऑफ दैट देन विल बी नो वैकेंसी बिकॉज़ इट इज सेल्फ ऑक्यूपाइड एंड द रेंट इज रिकॉर्डेबल इन आल्सो देयर इज नो वेंडर असेसमेंट सो डायरेक्टली आई विल राइट फॉर हाउस टू on loan for this part. I will rub that part, solve first. After that, we will solve the third part. So remember the amount. For this house, we got the answer of 11,250. So for your understanding, I am writing. So you won't get confused. House 1, income is what? 11,250. House 2, income is what? Less, minus what is square foot. For house 3, same. We are going to find out. So I will drop this information and it will be helpful to me in the third part as well. So this is another third part I am solving. It is regarding the raw house. So for that purpose I will get the daily information. So annual rent is going to be 36. Parent is 22, third is 39, standard rent is 13, tax paid by the owner is 1,000. Here in portion they have specified, I am not writing here, tax paid by the tenant. So that we are not going to include. Interest for the construction, current is what? 8,000. Capitalized is 12,000. For checking out the capitalizations in the gate, it is 1,700 gate. So we are going to get the advantage of that. Vacancy is also 1,000. And the bed tax is 1,000. So each and every information we have specified in the house. So I will have house 3. House 3 is what? The raw house. It is red out. So first of all, the step 1. What is step 1? You know that compare the municipal value and fair rent whichever is higher. Obviously the municipal and fair value is 42. Compare with standard rent whichever is lower. So standard rent is what? 30,000. So the first step answer is going to be what? 30,000. Whichever is lower. So that is going to be 30. The first answer is what? 30,000. Now step 2 answer. Step 2 answer is what? Actual rent received minus back tax. Or in recoverable you can. So actual rent you are going to receive say in the question is what 36,000. So 36,000 minus 1,000. So that is going to be 35. Now the step 3. So step 3 is going to be higher than step 1 and step 2. Higher between step 1 or step 2. So 35. Higher is what? 35. Now step 4. Step 4 is what? The step 3 answer minus the vacancy. So here the house is vacant for the 1 month. So 1 month vacant it is. So we are going to calculate. So step 3 answer minus vacancy. So step 3 answer is 39. So actual rent received is what? 36. 36 divided by 12. So 36 into 1 by 12. So 35,000 minus 3,000. This is going to be what? 32,000. So GAB is going to be 32,000. Now less tax paid by the owner. Tax paid by the owner is what? Rupees 1,000. So any is going to be 31,000. So I am getting the NAP as a 31,000. Now three steps you know that is the specific deductions. One is standard rate. The second part is one is the standard deduction of 30%. Second interest, and the third is capitalized interest. So NAP specific deduction. In that number, standard deduction at 30% of NAP.
Is what 60,000 means. income also 12,000. And from house sale, we are getting the profit of 16,300. So we are going to add. So total income from house property equals to. So the first part is going to be the house property one is what? The flat. Flat will be house one plus tenement. That is house two and plus the non house. That is house three. So equals to from that is 11,250. Second is minus 12,000 and the third is what? 16,300. So add 11,250 plus 16,300. Minus 15,500 is the answer. This is the income from house property of Yash Kumar. Of what? Yash Kumar. This is the Yash Kumar. So in this house, in this question we have solved the three adjustments. Two are let out and the one is self-occupied. So when you are letting out the house, all the steps are required for the GDP. But when the house is self-occupied, so there is no requirement. There is no need to calculate the GDP. Directly we are getting the answer NAP as a NAP, according to the section 23 sub section 2A. So all the information regarding the house 1, house 2, house 3, they have specified us, they have solved us. At last we got the income from the house property for the Yash Kumar is going to be the 15,550. So in the next lecture we are going to solve the next sum. Still we are going to solve the company sums for this chapter, then we will start the next chapter. So the answer is going to be 15,550 solid sum.